We have a new code challenge for you as part of the community spotlight for the month of September. This time, it's about testing your skills and learning the basics in ABAP. The challenge is very simple. You'll have to create an account on Exorcism and complete the challenge assigned for each week. If you're interested in participating in the challenge, read the blog post to learn more and see what this week's challenge is. We're looking forward to seeing all of your submissions. Don't forget to head over to the SAP Community Code Challenge, dive into the basics of ABAP thread in the Application Development Group to discuss, share, and ask questions throughout the challenge. We're looking forward to seeing all of your submissions throughout the month of September.
If you're in the United States or Canada, feel free to sign up for the SAP Builders Challenge, a virtual hackathon focusing on low-code tools, specifically SAP AppGyver and SAP Process Automation. Teams will consist of 5 people and ideally be made up of business users as well as professional developers. SAP will provide each team with their own SAP BTP tenant, with all of the proper entitlements and instances of SAP AppGyver and SAP Process Automation. You'll also be able to use for your project SAP API Business Hub, SAP Integration Suite, and SAP Business Application Studio. In early October, SAP will provide enablement sessions where instructors will get you up to speed on all of the tools. Then you'll have about 3 weeks to develop your project, during which a group of mentors, including me, will be able to answer any questions you have about SAP AppGyver or SAP Process Automation. Winners will be announced about 10 days later in mid-November. Registration starts early next week, so be on the lookout for a blog in the SAP AppGyver or SAP Process Automation community, which will have all of the details, including the great prizes. So good luck.
Within the last week, we've seen the release of 2 excellent blog posts that have done an incredible job of bookending the entire ABAP topic. First of all, we have a blog post by Carl Kessler on the evolution of ABAP itself. Now, this is part of the overall 50th anniversary celebration of SAP. And in this blog post, Carl does a great job of going down memory lane and exploring the entire history of the ABAP language and development tools. He starts with the earliest origins in the RFM, or sometimes referred to as R1 product. He has examples of the ABAP syntax as it's evolved from R1 to R2, kinds of things that you don't see very often these days. Then he talks about the client-server era, the introduction of the ABAP workbench, internet accessibility, ABAP object-oriented, all the way up through modern S4HANA and steampunk-based ABAP. Now, speaking of steampunk, Boris Gephardt released a blog post entitled Embedded Steampunk, Some More Details for ABAP Developers. Now, this is in conjunction with the fact that S4HANA Cloud 2208 has embedded steampunk released for general availability. Now, in this blog post, we see the evolution of using ABAP, more specifically, the BTP cloud-based version of ABAP, sometimes referred to as steampunk, for developing extensions, particularly those extensions for S4HANA Cloud. He talks about in this blog post what it is, and how it can be used to build those kinds of extensions. So regardless of where you are in your journey as an ABAP developer, I think these are 2 blog posts that every ABAP developer should read, one detailing the history and one looking ahead to the bright future for ABAP development.
Here's a couple of items related to the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model. That's CAP to you and me. First of all, there's a great blog post by Robert Witt that describes an enhancement that was recently released. The enhancement is to the CDS importer, which now allows it to generate service models from OpenAPI specifications. What does this mean? Well, basically, you can properly incorporate third-party HTTP APIs that are described by OpenAPI documents, and the CDS importer or create a service definition with unbound actions and functions for all of the operations. By the way, if you're wondering about what unbound actions and functions are, they're a feature of OData V4, you might want to take a look at a recent hands-on SAP Dev livestream episode where we cover exactly this topic in our Back to Basics series on OData. Anyway, check out Robert's blog post, which has a really nice detailed example that he walks through using the Open Weather Map REST API. Another CAP related item, there's the third customer roundtable that's been announced. It's taking place next month in October, and it will feature CAP's chief product owner, Daniel Hutzel, as well as an array of product owners and key development managers. You can be sure that there's going to be some great detailed in-depth discussion and Q&A in that event. Check out Michael's blog post for the details of this third customer roundtable, including how to register.